movie of Elsinore, you're in for a treat. It's been running since Wednesday and we've had a great crowd and great feedback, so it's really, really great for them. It's running for the rest of the summer, Wednesday to Friday. All the details of our lunchtime performances are on the website, so please do check it out. And if you could make sure that your mobile phones are switched off, and just in case there is a need to have a clearance, it's that door that you came in. Thank you very much.
Your hair, girl. That's my job.
Oh, Ruby, you have to make me especially beautiful.
Honey, this is a comb, not a magic wand.
I mean it. I have to look really good tonight.
What's the big occasion?
I'm going to be a princess.
Yeah, trust me, honey, you've been a princess for a long time.
No, I mean a real princess, with a tiara and everything.
Who died?
Nobody died.
I thought with you people, every time someone dies, you all move up one.
I'm going to marry a prince.
He told you he was a prince?
He is a prince.
I'd be careful if I were you, Chad. A lot of frogs walking around these days claiming to be princes.
This one's an old frog.
Everyone in the background checking him? At least Google him. Sure, every guy that knows what a pair of tights and a sword says he's a prince.
Ruby, I'm going to marry Prince Hamlet.
Well, have a minute here. You're going to marry the Prince of Darkness?
You shouldn't say those things about him.
Honey, that man could depress a laughing hyena.
He's got a lot on his mind.
He's a prince. He doesn't do friggin' jack. What can even his mind?
Father.
His father's dead.
That's the problem.
So what are you telling me, the old guy's not dead?
Oh no, he's dead, all right.
What's the freaking problem?
Hamlet thinks.
What? He thinks what?
Oh, I really shouldn't say anything.
All right. Fine with me, child. Yes, me, I wouldn't pay much attention. All these royals are a couple of raisins short of a Danish. It's what happens when cousins marry cousins.
Hamlet doesn't think his father died of natural causes.
Hell, girl, this is Elsinore. Nobody dies as a natural causes.
You have to promise not to tell a soul.
My lips are sealed.
Well, Hamlet thinks that his stepfather...
You mean the new king?
Right, yeah. Claudius. Hamlet thinks that the new king had something to do with his father's... Well...
He thinks the new king croaked his own neck.
Something like that.
Would that be my guess?
You really think the king could do something so gross?
And like I said, honey, this is Denmark. There's always something rotten going on somewhere, and you can quote me on that. So, did the Prince of Indecision figure this all out by his lonesome?
Not exactly.
Yeah, just how exactly.
You have to promise not to whisper a word of this to anyone.
You know what I always say, child. What happens at Ruby's...
Stays at Ruby's. His father told him.
His father's dead.
That's why you can't tell anyone.
Why would I want to?
I know, it's hard to believe.
Oh, no, yeah, hard to believe. Hamlet's dead father told him that his uncle, King Claudius, bumped him off.
That's it in a nutshell?
I'd say nutshell was an excellent choice of word. And you're going to marry this guy?
When he asks me.
Hold on, just a cat and pick a minute here. He hasn't asked to marry him yet.
Well, not in so many words.
Yeah, well, when he does, it'll be in so many words you won't understand what the hell he's talking about. How well do you know this Prince Hamlet?
Well, let's just say well enough.
Take it from someone who's been there, honey. Sometimes well enough ain't good enough.
I know he loves me.
He told you that?
Well...
Not in so many words. For the life of me, I'll never understand why women let men off the hook when it comes to saying, I love you.
Because I know he does.
Actually, you don't know Jack. Especially when it comes to men.
I know how he feels by the way he looks at me.
Don't confuse my opium with interest.
He loves me and I'm going to marry him.
Fine with me, child. It's your life. Prince Hamlet just never seemed the marrying kind to me, if you know what I mean.
No, I don't know what you mean.
Your ma was hanging around with them two guys, Rosenbergers and Guildenstern.
Rosencrantz and Guildenstern.
Yeah. They're both little light and leotards, if you ask me.
They were all friends in college. There is nothing wrong with Hamlet.
I just never seen him hang out with any girls. No offence, honey, but he just seems a real mama's boy to me.
Hamlet loves his mother.
So did Oedipus.
Well, he must have been a very good son, this Oedipus.
And for a while, not a bad husband.
Hamlet's just not too happy with his mother these days.
Oh, jeez, what's his problem?
He thinks she married his uncle too soon after his father's death.
Oh, really? He thinks the next day was too soon?
Don't make jokes, Ruby.
Who's making jokes? To use the leftovers for the funeral to cater for the wedding.
Hamlet thinks there's something going on between Claudius and Gertrude even before.
He thinks?
Mm-hmm.
He thinks. Hey, girl, everybody in Elsinore, Gertrude was steaming up the sheets with Claudius.
I didn't know it.
Are you blind, child? Even at the funeral, he had his hand firmly planted on her royal ass. I mean, have you thought of suggesting to the prince that maybe he seeks a little professional help? I mean, I see dead people. Give me a friggin' break here.
Ruby, what do you think I should do?
What's your father say?
Neither a borrower nor a lender be.
Does your father think you're going into business with Prince Hamlet?
No, that's how my father speaks. To thine own self be true, and it follows as night the day, yet... Oh, Ruby, your dream!
We're all such stuff as dreams are made of, and you can quote me on that.
Ruby, I swear, if Hamlet doesn't ask me to marry him, I'll actually kill myself.
No, child, you mustn't speak that way. You listen to Ruby. Men are like ferry boats. If you miss one, another will come along in an hour. So if I were you, I wouldn't worry about a thing. Run along.
Wish me luck!
Luck! You're gonna need it.
Good afternoon, Your Majesty.
Darling!
Your Majesty!
Rosie, hi.
Ruby, my name is Ruby, Your Highness.
Who's Ruby?
Ruby? My name is Ruby, Your Highness.
Oh, are you contradicting your queen?
No, ma'am, I was merely pointing out.
One does not point out their queen.
Yes, Your Haughtiness. Well, what will it be today?
Oh, just a touch-up.
Yeah, you want me to do something with those roots?
I am the queen. I do not have roots. I have transitions.
Whatever you say. So, how are you? I haven't seen you since before your wedding, I suppose. A congrats are in order.
Thank you, Rita.
As well as condolences.
Condolences? What are you talking about?
Condolences? And the death of your husband?
Claudius is not dead. He's very much alive. In fact, we only...
I mean, the late king, the one before this one.
Oh, yes. Yeah. The late king. Yes, he is dead and buried.
Although still very active from what I hear.
What are you talking about, Ruthie?
Nothing, Your Grace. So, everything is satisfactory with you and the new king?
Oh, everything is very satisfactory, Rhonda.
Yeah, happy to hear it.
Things couldn't be more satisfactory.
Oh, that's good.
As a matter of fact, I can't remember the last time I've been so satisfied and on such a regular basis.
Well, you go, Highness.
Are you married, Rhoda?
Ruby?
Who is Ruby?
Not important, Your Majesty. And to answer your question, I was married once. Mm,
was he a loving man?
That's what every woman I can would say.
My first husband was not a loving man.
I'm sorry to hear that, ma'am.
In fact, my first husband was a cold man, a very cold man.
Couldn't be much colder than what he is right now.
Perhaps there are women who prefer a man who pays them no attention, leaves them completely alone. A man who never... How should I put this? A man who never...
Shows them the respect and tenderness they deserve.
Tenderness, tenderness. I'm talking about a man who never slips them the high, hard one. Sweeps out the chimney, threads the old needle, lays a little pipe now and then.
Of course, Your Majesty. What could I be thinking of?
Indeed. And then along came Claudius.
Slow walking Claudius. Slow talking Claudius. You're speaking, of course, of the new king. Your late husband's brother, your son's
Yes. Claudius is different than his brother.
For one thing, he's alive.
He's warm.
Warm is a good thing in a man.
He's considerate.
A real treat these days.
And loving. Very, 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 very loving.
There's certainly a new glow in those royal cheeks.
I can tell you this because you are a woman, Rachel. With someone in your profession, one can't always be sure.
Oh, you can be sure. Your homophobicness.
When I am with him, all I want to do is... Oh, how should I put it? All I want to do is...
Rest in his hands, enjoy his company, bask in his adulation.
Do the horizontal mambo, excavate the tunnel of love, parallel park, ride the pony slur.
I get the picture, your humpiness.
My son doesn't understand that.
He's young, he'll learn.
Do you really think so?
Time heals all wounds. Mm,
perhaps you're right.
I think that's it.
Are you coming to the play tonight?
What play is that, Your Majesty?
Oh, Hamlet has commissioned a play to be performed in the castle tonight. It's called The Mousetrap. You must come.
Ah, plays aren't really my thing. I like something with a little action. Something I can get down with. Something funky.
One does not turn down an invitation from her queen just because it doesn't rise or sink to the required level of funkiness.
Yes, yes, you're supercilious.
I shall leave two tickets for you.
My king.
My queen. Ruby, ruby, ruby.
King, king, king.
Ruby, ruby, ruby.
King, king, king.
A sight for sore eyes, Ruby.
You're looking very regal yourself.
I'm feeling very regal.
I haven't seen you since before your coronation.
Has it been that long, Ruby?
At least. Is it true what they say, Your Highness?
What's that, Ruby?
That it's good to be king.
Well, it doesn't suck, I can tell you that. The power, the wealth, the respect. But mostly the power. God, I love power. People stand when you walk into a room. They don't sit until you sit. They do everything you tell them to do. They laugh at all your jokes. Right now, back at the castle, there are actually people lining up waiting to kiss my ring.
So that's what all the bowing's about.
And the women. I can't turn around without some beautiful woman offering me, well, what beautiful women have to offer. You get the picture.
In a frame.
But of course, I'm faithful to the queen.
Of course.
Completely faithful.
Completely faithful.
Totally and completely faithful.
Totally and completely faithful.
100% without.
What's her name?
Annabella. She's a lady in waiting.
Obviously, she ain't waiting no more.
Ruby, Ruby, Ruby.
King, king, king.
I may be King Ruby.
Here it comes.
But I'm still a man.
If you weren't the man, you wouldn't be the king.
Exactly.
Queen.
You won't say anything to the. I knew I could count on you, Ruby.
Usual trim, Majesty.
Please. My stepson's putting on some cockamini play tonight, and his mother insists that I go.
Then I'll see you there.
You're going?
Let's just say the Queen extended me an invitation I couldn't refuse.
And there's no getting out for either of us. Do you have any children, Ruby?
None that I know of.
What?
It's a joke.
Ah, yes, a joke. No one tells me jokes anymore. Oh,
that's too bad.
We're all afraid of being funnier than the King.
Heavy lies the head that wears the crown.
Very perceptive, Ruby. Who said that?
I just did.
Oh. My stepson hates me, Ruby.
He's just a little confused.
Confused? He's a fruitcake. But he still hates me for marrying his mother.
Among other things.
What's that?
It's not easy for a child when one parent dies and the other remarries the next day.
Perhaps we did rush things a tad, but it's a cruel world out there for a woman by herself without a man to protect her.
I suppose. Last thing I know, it's the only man who said he was going to protect me. Protected me right out of my life savings.
I couldn't leave my brother's widow alone.
That's what I hear.
And now her son wants me dead.
Really? Dead? Hamlet?
Those are the rumours. You haven't heard anything, Ruby. I'm sure people tell you things.
Not me, no, Ava.
Well, here's my private number. If you do hear anything, give me a call. You'd have the undying gratitude of a grateful king.
If I hear anything.
Thank you, Ruby. Oh, Ruby.
Yes, Your Majesty.
Bring toothpicks.
Excuse me?
Bring toothpicks for the play. Drop your eyes open and hear Hamlet's directed. It's going to be a real yawn. What have you entered this way? What have you entered this way? What have you entered this way? What have you played it this way? Oh,
you
can always.
Finished. Yes.
To be or not to be?
Well, look at the cat drag then. Sit up straight, will you?
Why, Ruby?
Why sit up straight? Why not sit slumped forward? Or maybe to one side? Or just fall on the ground? Curl up in a ball!
Get up! You can't go to your own play looking like this tonight.
What difference does it make, Ruby? Whether I look like this, or look like that, just tie the whole thing back in a ponytail.
Ponytail? Man, ponytails are so yesterday. You need something that says young, hip, now.
How about big, thick sideburns? Down to here.
Yeah, I don't think so. You're the prince, not the king.
What difference does it make, Ruby, what my hair looks like? A rogue and a peasant slave am I.
Well, your hair says rogue and peasant slob. Besides, there's nothing like a new do to lift the clouds of doom, raise the spirits, boost the confidence and all that.
And what do you suggest, Ruby? What could ever lift the clouds of doom that hover over my ear-troubled brow?
Bangs.
Bangs?
Bangs.
Surely you jest.
From what I hear, they're all the rage in England now. Prince Valiant has beaten them off with a stick.
Really? With a stick? To have bangs or not to have bangs.
You're going to start that again, are you?
Whether 'tis nobler to tie one's hair in a ponytail.
If you keep that up and I'm going to shave you bald.
Bangs it is.
Tell me about this play of yours.
Well, actually, it's a ploy.
A ploy?
To catch the conscience of the king.
But what's the play?
The ploy.
But isn't the ploy the thing to catch the conscience of the
well,
king?
Well, no, that's the play.
Then what's the play?
The mousetrap.
What's the mousetrap have anything to do with this?
It's the play.
Oh, the mousetrap is the play!
Yes, yes.
Then what's the ploy?
The play.
The ploy's the play.
Precisely, and the play is the mousetrap.
So what you're saying is, the play's the ploy, and the ploy's the play, and the play's the mousetrap.
Yes, and it's a play within a play.
Excuse me?
The mousetrap.
What about the mousetrap?
It's a play within a play.
The mousetrap's a play within a play.
And that's what makes it a ploy.
So what you're saying is, the play is a ploy, and the ploy is a play, and a play's a play within a play, and it's a play within a play that makes a play a ploy.
Precisely. You mustn't repeat that to anyone.
I don't think I could if I wanted to. Does your girlfriend know anything about this?
Girlfriend? What girlfriend? I don't have a girlfriend.
Ophelia.
Ophelia. She's still telling everyone that she's my girlfriend.
She thinks you're going to pop the question.
What question?
Well, it ain't to be or not to be, I can tell you that much.
She thinks I'm going to ask her to marry me.
That's what she thinks.
Where did she get the idea that I wanted to marry her?
Apparently from you.
I've got enough on my plate. My father is dead, my uncle is the king, and my mother is...
Let's not go there, right?
Point is, I don't need some girl mooning after me all the time. She should get her to a nunnery!
That girl's looking for, she ain't gonna find a no nunnery.
Well, she's not gonna find it with me either.
A bit of advice, if you don't mind me saying so. Let the child down easy, she's young, impressionable, and highly strong.
Tell me about it. I've played lutes that weren't strung as tight.
I'd just be careful if I were you.
You know, it's not easy being me, Ruby.
Right. Prince of the realm, my killer job. Who'd ever want it?
Oh, so speaking of killer jobs, I may have to kill my uncle.
You may have to kill your uncle?
You must promise not to breathe a word of it to any other soul.
My lips are sealed.
Do you promise?
Only if I'm lying, I'm dying.
Well, it's not a sure thing yet.
Not killing your uncle?
I have to be sure he actually did murder my father.
You really think your uncle murdered your father?
I'm not 100% positive.
Yeah, of course.
No,
not.
I have it from a very reliable source.
A reliable source? And who might that reliable source be?
My father.
Unless I read the papers wrong, your daddy's dead.
But to be precise, it was my father's ghost who taught me.
Your father's ghost taught you?
That's right.
Are you sure just let the sound of your college buddies punking you?
That's in the realm of possibility, I suppose.
So there's a chance you won't kill your uncle?
Right now, it's about 50-50.
50-50?
No, well, I wouldn't want to rush
yeah,
into
of course,
it.
Not your Hamlet.
I mean, what if he didn't murder my father?
Right, what if?
Then I'd be killing him for nothing.
And you wouldn't want to kill your uncle based on bad intelligence?
But what if he did kill my father?
That's a whole different kettle of bits now, isn't it?
Then there's the matter of justice.
Oh yeah, justice. Can't forget justice.
Ruby, do I have the right to take his life because he took my father's life? But I mean, he is the king, and to raise a sword against your own king is the highest crime one can commit.
But then again, conscience does make cowards of us all.
Well, I never thought of that. Conscience does make cowards of us all. Yes, I could blame the whole thing on my conscience. I wouldn't have to do anything.
Yeah, it's a thought.
But I ask you, Ruby, do I have the right to take his life? But he is the king, and if I don't render justice, who will? But if that king...
Ruby here.
Right. If that king attained his crown by raising his sword against his king...
Yes, it could if I hear anything.
No, but can two rights make a wrong?
Yeah, I wouldn't worry about anything.
Can right and a wrong make a right?
Yeah, as much chance as being whacked as me and your stepson do become the Queen of friggin' England.
Can two wrongs make a right?
Yeah, no problem, no problem.
Can two rights make a left? To be or not to be? That is the question. Whether it is nobler to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune, or to rise up against a sea of bubbles? You have cuddles! Doubles!
Save me a seat. Ever thought of pain sometime?
The presence of a dead man has the tendency to frighten most people.
Well, I ain't most people.
Oh. No, you're not, Ruby. You're the last honest person in Denmark.
Which ain't saying much when you get right down to it.
What am I going to do, Ruby?
We could give you a little spray tan. The Casper look is so 90s.
I'm talking about my family. My brother murdered me. My wife took him into her bed before my body was even cold. My son won't even avenge my death.
What family doesn't have its problems?
You tricked Gertrude and Claudius. Had something going on before he poured the poison in my ear.
I wouldn't know, Your Majesty.
And if you did, you wouldn't tell me, would you?
What happens at Ruby's?
Stays at Ruby's, I know. I could have used ministers like you, Ruby. People who know how to keep their mouth shut, unlike my son.
He's young, Your Highness.
He's 32 years old, Ruby. When I was 32, I conquered half a dozen neighboring tribes, killed God knows how many more, and impregnated 500 of their women.
Oh, you're a doer, Majesty.
If my father's brother had killed my father and married my mother, I'd have roasted a bastard over a spit. I'd have venisoned to pigs.
Each generation has its own way of dealing with conflict.
I'd have had his head on a pike. I'd have severed his limbs, I'd have...
Tied him up in chains and went all 50 shades of grey on him.
What?
Oh, sorry, Your Majesty. Got a little carried away there.
So how are things with you, Ruby?
I can't complain.
Still seeing the rope maker?
No, I couldn't get him to tie the knot.
That's the trouble with young people today. No sense of commitment. Take my son, for instance. To be... or not to be. What's the problem? Just stab the son of a bitch. Did I ever tell you about the time I killed 3 men with one thrust of my sword?
Oh, yes, Your Majesty. Many times.
It was the battle of... death is hell on the memory, Ruby. Anyway, there they were, all lined up in a nice, neat row, and I took my sword, and I shoved it so hard to them. Thank you.
Thank you.